Very good morning, my dear students, and welcome back to our maths class. As you have observed, in previous class we have solved exercise 4.3, and in that you have studied the exercise problems, and after that what do you mean by the long division method, and even what do you mean by remainder theorem. Yes, so be careful with the wordings, because if the problem is given, for example, if the polynomial equation is given that you have to divide by the linear equation by the remainder theorem, then you have to go for the remainder theorem. If the problem is given such that the polynomial equation is divided by the linear equation, that means any one equation they will give, like x plus 1, x plus 5, so like that. If that is divided by the polynomial equation is divided by the linear equation by the long division method, if at all they have mentioned that term means, then you have to solve by the long division method only. Instead of that, when they have mentioned, instead of if they have mentioned as long division method, you solve by the remainder theorem means, definitely it will went wrong then. So be careful with the sentence, read the questions very carefully whenever it is given, then according to that you have to solve. Okay, if in the question they have not mentioned any method means, then you can follow any one of the method which is preferable to you, and I will prefer you that just go through the all the methods properly, and even long division methods, because long division method is applicable even for even next year also. So study that one properly, practice that one, write and solve, so it will be helpful for you further. So today we will move towards our further exercise, that is 2.4, and in this exercise we are studying about factorization of the polynomial. So don't worry about the wordings, that we will learn in the exercise only. And in the reader, some of the examples is given on the basis of long division methods. So just go through that one, because you have studied in 8th standard also. So if at all there is any doubt, you can ask with me. I will help you how to solve that problems. And remember the equations of the remainder theorem and even long division method. So these are the important things you have to remember. So I hope all of you have understood the previous class. Then today we will start with exercise 2.4. Sorry, this one is, so it is 2.4. They have given as 4.4. So it is 2.4. In that first one, first problem we'll solve. Determine which of the following polynomial has x plus 1 factor. So factor terms you have studied in a previous exercise also. What you are doing? You are solving the equation. This is the polynomial equation which is divided by the 7 plus 3x, which is the linear equation. From that, if the remainder is 0, then it is a factor of the equation. Okay, so I will tell this one is a polynomial equation. Yes, so if 7 plus 3x is the factor, then the remainder is 0. If it is not, the remainder is not equal to 0. That same method continues here. So method of solving is similar to that one only. So let's start with first problem. So this is the first problem. They have given the equation x cube x square plus of x plus of 1. What you have to determine? Determine which of the following polynomial, that means this is our polynomial equation, has x plus 1 a factor. So if it is a factor, then the remainder is 0. If it is not a factor, then the remainder is if it is equal to 0, then it is definitely a factor. Okay, if it is not equal to 0, then it is not a factor. So remainder, if the remainder is equal to 0, if the remainder is not equal to 0, then it is not a factor of that given polynomial. Okay, so for that, what they have given, x plus 1 is a factor. Yes, so this one is equal to 0 as it is a equation. So this equation is our p of x. Okay, so the equation is p of x. I will write that one also. P of x is equal to x cube plus of x square plus of x plus of 1, and x plus 1 is equal to 0 as they have given. We have to check for whether it is a factor of this equation or not. For that you have to solve for the x value. Yes, so x is equal to, as it is a plus 1, if it comes to the right hand side it will become minus 1. So now we got x value, then what we have to do? we have to substitute that x value in our polynomial equation, that is p of x. P of x means p of minus 1. We are substituting the minus 1 value in our polynomial equation. So it is x cube. X cube means which is equal to minus 1 cube plus of x square, that means minus 1 whole to the power square plus minus 1, as it is the x, I will keep it in the bracket, plus of 1. Okay, now it is minus 1 cube. So minus 1 cube means minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1. As I told, if it is a 3, if it is twice means it will get cancelled, or minus 1 into minus 1 will become plus. As it is a 3 times multiple, then the minus sign will remain as it is. 1 cube is 1. Now you observe minus 1 into minus 1, that is 2 times, means it will become positive 1. So as it is a minus, plus into minus, that is minus 1 plus of 1. You can observe minus 1 plus 1, that is 0, or minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled, minus 1 plus 1 get cancelled, then the remaining is 0. That means p of minus 1, the polynomial of the given equation, remainder is 0. Yes, if the remainder is 0, then what it says, it is the x plus 1 is the factor of the given equation, that we will write. As it is equal to 0, therefore the x plus 1 is a factor of equation p of x. Or you can write p of x, you can write, or x cube plus of x square plus of x plus 1 equation also you can write. It depends on you. Okay, so second problem. So in the second problem, you can observe, as they have given the equation, we will write that one as a polynomial equation. P of x is equal to x raised to 4 plus of x cube plus of x square plus of x plus of 1. Here, as they have given for the same, the question is same, in that sub questions are there. So determine which of the following polynomial has x plus 1 as a factor. So x plus 1 they have given. So x plus 1 is equal to 0 we'll consider. From this you have to find x value. So x is equal to minus 1. So this is same for all four sub problems. Okay, so here also it is minus 1. In third problem also it is minus, and fourth problem also it is minus 1. So p of minus 1. Here you have to substitute the minus 1 value in our given polynomial equation, which is equal to x raised to 4 means minus 1 raised to 4 plus of x cube means minus 1 raised to cube plus of minus 1 square plus of minus 1, in bracket you write it, plus of 1. So minus 1 raised to 4, as it is a 4, minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1 into minus 1, that is plus plus. So it will become plus. As it is an even number, the sign will also become positive. So minus 1 cube, as it is the odd, minus minus into minus plus, plus into minus will become again minus. So it is minus 1 plus of minus 1 square will be 1, and it is a minus 1, I will keep it in the bracket, plus of 1. Now we can observe 1 minus 1 plus 1, then it is minus 1 plus 1. So now you can observe plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, plus 1 minus 1 get cancelled, remaining is 1. Yes, so p of minus 1 is equal to 1. That means our remainder is not equal to 0. If the remainder is not equal to 0, then x plus 1 is not a factor of p of x, that is our given equation. So here we will write x plus 1 is not a factor of, here we will write the equation, factor of x to the power 4 x cube plus of x square plus of x plus 1. So this is second question. Let's move towards third one. So even in third problem, as they have given x plus 1 is the factor or not, so x plus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1. This we have to substitute in our p of x equation, so that is polynomial equation. Yes, so we'll substitute directly. So p of minus 1, which is equal to x raised to 4, that means 1 minus 1 to the power 4 plus of 3 into the bracket minus 1, in place of x you have to substitute the value as minus 1. So it is minus 1 cube plus of 3x square. 3 into the bracket minus 1 square plus of minus 1. Now the value of minus 1 we have subtracted, we have substituted in our equation, that is our polynomial equation. We can solve now. Minus 1 to the power 4, that means as it is the even, the minus 1 term, minus 1 into minus 1, minus 1 into minus 1, again it will be 4 times, means it is a positive. Plus of 3 is here, so 3 into the bracket minus 1 cube. So minus 1 cube, that the sign will remain as minus 1, plus of 3 into the bracket minus 1 square. 1 square. Square means 2 times multiply, so it will become positive 1 plus of minus 1, that is minus 1. Directly I will write. So it is 1 plus 3 into minus 1. 3 into 1 is 3, sign is minus. So plus 3 into plus 1, so 3 into 1 is 1, so the sign is 3 minus 1. Now you can observe, so I left here one thing, so it is x to the power 4, 3x cube, 3x square, x, okay, plus 1 I left, plus 1, so sorry, it is plus 1, okay, so 1, 3 into minus 1, that is minus 3, 3 into 1 is 3, minus 1, then here remaining is 1. So here you can observe it is plus 1, plus 1, minus 1 get cancelled, minus 3, plus 3 get cancelled, and the remaining is 1. That means P of minus 1, our remainder is equal to 1. That means which is not equal to 0. If it is not equal to 0, then it is, therefore x plus 1 is not a factor of, not a factor of given equation, that is our polynomial equation, x raised to 4 plus of 3x cube plus of 3x square plus x plus 1. Okay, so this is third problem. Let's observe fourth one. So in fourth problem, as we know that x plus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to minus 1, we have to substitute this one in our polynomial equation, that is p of minus 1, which is equal to, as they have given x cube, minus 1 to the power cube plus minus of into the bracket minus 1 square minus of 2, in bracket we will write plus of root 2, x value as they have given it is minus 1, in bracket I will write plus of minus plus of root 2. So this what we have substituted x value in our given polynomial equation. Now minus 1 cube is, as it is a cube, 3 times means the negative sign will remain as it is. So minus 1 square. So minus 1 square is, minus 1 square is plus 1. Plus 1 into minus 1. So that is minus 1. So I'll write directly. And now you observe here, be careful with this. As it is the bracket terms, it will multiply. Yes. So here also you can observe x 2 plus of root 2, bracket completes x. That means this two terms are multiplied, and don't think that only it will multiply with one term or the first or the second term. The x will multiply both the terms because bracket related to this term. Yes, so this will multiply, and even you can observe this sign also, as it is the negative term, so we'll keep that one as it is. As it is minus 1 into 2, so if you multiply this one, minus 2 minus into 2, that is minus 2, minus 2 into minus 1. What we will do, first we will multiply the minus terms, then we'll keep the bracket like that, then we will continue. Okay, so minus term I will keep here only. First I will multiply this term inside. Okay, 2 into minus 1, so that is minus 2, minus 1 into plus root 2, so root 2 into 1 is root 2, as it is a minus, root 2 plus of root 2, we'll keep like that only. Now you can solve easily. So minus 1, minus 1, as it is a minus minus terms, you have to add the term and use the sign of minus only. So it is minus 2, minus, as this minus is related to this bracket term, yes, so minus into minus, so that is plus 2, minus into minus, that is plus root 2, plus of root 2. So now minus 2 and plus 2 will get cancelled. It is a plus root 2 and plus root 2. That means 2 root of 2. So don't think that root 2 plus of root 2, don't write root 4. Okay, don't write root 4, it is wrong. When it is a root 4, when 2 into 2 you will do, that time it is a root 4 you can do. Okay, but when you are, as it is addition, root 2 plus of root 2, as it is addition means the coefficient is 1 here, the coefficient is 1. So there are two terms, x plus x. How you are writing? 2x you are writing, not x square. Yes, so you are writing 2x like that. It is 2, which term here? Root 2. So that means p of minus 1, our answer is 2 root 2. If it is a 2 root 2, then it is not equal to 0. The remainder is not equal to 0. If the remainder is not equal to 0, then it is not a factor of a given equation. So write it down. Therefore, x plus 1 is not a factor of, is not a factor of given polynomial equation, that is x cube minus x square minus 2 into the bracket plus root 2 x plus of root 2. So this is about our first main question in that exercise 2.4. in the second question now, same problem, you can observe, use the factor theorem to determine whether g of x, that means another linear equation, is a factor of p of x. This is the polynomial equation in each of the following. Here g of x you have to consider as a one equation, and p of x is your polynomial equation, and you are substituting the value of x in a, your polynomial equation. So for that you can observe in the question, first question, p of x is equal to 2x cube plus of x square minus 2x minus 1, and g of x they have given as it is a linear equation, x plus 1. So if it is a x plus 1, why it is a linear equation? Because x to the power is 1, so it is a linear equation. So x plus g of x you have to consider g of x value, that is x plus 1 is equal to 0. If x plus 1 is equal to 0, then x is equal to minus 1. Yes, so now you got the x value that you have to substitute in a polynomial equation. So p of minus 1, which is equal to 2x cube. So 2 as the equation they have given, 2x cube, 2 into the bracket minus 1 cube plus of minus 1 square, as it is a x square, minus 2 into the bracket, x means minus 1 minus of 1. So as it is 2 minus 1 cube is minus 1 plus of 1 square, minus 1 square is plus 1. So minus 2 into minus 1, so minus into minus plus, 2 into 1 is 2 minus 1. So it is minus 2, plus 1 and minus 1 I will cancel here only. So 2 into minus 1 is minus 2 plus of 2. Minus 2 and plus 2 will get cancelled, and p of minus 1 is equal to 0. If it is a 0, then it is a definitely factor of the term. Yes, so here just mention g of x is a factor of, here we will directly write, okay, g of x is a factor of polynomial equation, that is p of x. So second problem, I hope now you are perfect with these problems. Just what you have to do, from the linear equation you have to get the value of x. That value of x you have to substitute in your polynomial equation. So that's it. So first, as they have given, g of x is equal to x plus 2, which is equal to 0. We have to consider, from that we have to find the value of x. So x is equal to, as it is a plus 2 here, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become minus 2. And as I have observed in your answers sheet, some of the students, how you are solving means, if it is x plus 2, as it is the x term and it is the constant term, so you can't add these terms. Yes, so if it is a x square and x, if it is there, so you can't add these terms because it is a x square and this one is a x. So if it is x square plus of 2x square or any x square, 3x square, 4x square, x square, x square terms are there, then only you can add. If the terms are same, then only you can add. Okay, so as I have observed in our answer sheet, some of the students has written 2x plus 2 is equal to 4x you wrote. So this you can observe, variable is there, here there is no variable. So whether it is possible to add? No, the terms, the constant terms you can add with the constant term only, not with a variable. and variable, if the variables are same, like if it is x square, here also x square, here also x square, then you can add. If one is x square, another one is x, or one is x cube, another one is x square, you can't add the terms. If there are similar terms are there, then only you can add. So please remember those things, because that are the basic things which you have to learn in the algebra. So please practice those things, learn the concept, that one. So let's solve this problem. So x is equal to minus 2 we got, that we have to substitute in our given polynomial equation. So this you don't write, I explained for you. So it is p of x, that means p of minus 2, as we got the value of x. So that you have to substitute in equation. X cube means minus 2 to the power cube plus of 3 into the bracket minus 2. In place of x, I am substituting the value as minus 2. Minus 2 square plus of 3 minus 2 into the bracket minus 2, as it is a 3x plus of 1. So minus 2 cube. Now it is a 2 cube, not 1 cube. 2 into 2, 4. 4 2s are, again it is 8. So as it is the term minus, so as it is a cube, it will remain as it is. The sign will be minus 8. Then plus of, as it is a 2 square, I will write 3 into the bracket minus 2 square. Minus 2 square, the sign will get changed to the positive, and 2 square, 2 into 2, it is 4. Plus 3 into minus, 3 2s are 6, plus into minus, that is minus plus 1. Now minus 8, I will keep as it is, I will multiply this term, 4 3s are 12, minus 6 plus 1. Now you can add the term, subtract, or anything you can do. So what I will do, 12 plus 1, I will do 13, and so again here minus 8 and minus 6. 8 plus 2, 10, 14, so minus minus, minus 14. So P of minus 2 plus 13 minus 14, you have to subtract and use the sign of the bigger number. So bigger number is minus 14, so sign will be minus 14 minus 13 will be 1. So which is not equal to 0. If it is not equal to 0, then G of X, as they have given G of X here, so G of X is not a factor of given polynomial equation, factor of polynomial equation P of X. So this is second problem. Let's move towards third one. So third problem, similar to that, as they have given G of X is equal to X minus 3, which is equal to 0, you have to consider, as X is equal to, as it is a minus, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become positive. So X is equal to 3 you got. X is equal to 3, that value you have to substitute in P of X, that is our given polynomial equation. So P into the bracket 3, which is equal to X cube means 3 cube minus 4, 3 square plus of 3 plus 6. So 3 cube, 3 into 3 into 3. So 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are, it is 27. It is 27. 27 means 3 cube, as it is a positive, 27 minus 4 into the bracket 3 square, 3 into 3, that is 9, plus 3 plus of 6. So 27 minus 4, minus 4 into 9, so it is 36. 9 4s are 36 plus of 3 plus of 6. So we'll add the terms, whatever it is there. 27 plus 3, it is 30, 30 plus 6, 36, 36 minus of 36. So as it is, 36 is a positive and it is negative, it will get cancelled. P of 3, which is equal to 0. That means this G of X, which is equal to 0, means G of X is a factor of given polynomial equation, factor of P of X. So this is about our third problem. Let's move towards question number third in exercise main problem, that is question number third. So question number third, find the value of k if x minus 1 is the factor of p of x. So they have given the factor, that is x minus 1, in a polynomial equation. So they have given the polynomial equation, similar to that you have to find here the value k, means the constant term they have given alphabet, yes. So you have to find the value of that terms. So that's it. So for that, what you have to do, as they have given x minus 1, so consider x minus 1 is equal to 0. That means x is equal to, as it is the minus, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become positive. So x is equal to 1. So you got x is equal to 1. So x is equal to 1, you have to substitute in given equation. So p of 1 is equal to x square, means it is 1 square plus of 1 plus of k. Because we don't know the value of k, yes, you have to find that value. So p of 1, 1 square is 1 plus of 1 plus of k. So 1 plus 1 is 2 plus of k. Now you want the value of k, means what you have to do? You have to take this equation is equal to 0. So from this, is it possible to consider, is it possible to find the k value? Yes, definitely. Keep the k here only. This 2 you have to take to the right hand side. If you take this one to the right hand side, as it is a positive, it will become minus 2. As it is a plus 2, it will come as minus 2. So k is equal to minus 2. This is the first problem. To solve the second problem, similar to that, as they have given x minus 1 is the factor. So x minus 1 is equal to 0, x is equal to positive 1. This you have to substitute in a given equation, that is p of 1 is equal to 2x square. So x value is 1, 1 square plus of k we will keep as it is, and x is here, so we will substitute the value of x as positive 1 plus of root 2. 2 into 1 square, that means 2 into the bracket 1, k into 1, it is k plus of root 2. So it is 2 plus k plus of root 2. So here you want the value of k, yes, so I have written root k, sorry, it is 2 plus k plus root 2. You want the value of k, for that you have to take this equation as the equal to 0. If you want the k value here, means you have to keep this one here only, as it is a positive, and other terms you have to take that side. So as it is a plus 2, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become minus 2, and as it is a plus root 2, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become minus 2. Here you can stop, or you another one step you can do, k is equal to, as minus we will take common, 2 plus root 2. So even this is our answer. So let's move towards third problem. So in third problem, as we know that it is x minus 1 is equal to 0. So x value is positive 1. That means p of 1 is equal to, you have to substitute 1 positive 1 value in place of x. So k into the bracket plus 1 square minus of root 2 into the bracket 1 plus of 1. So k into 1 square is 1 square is 1, k into 1 is k only. So minus 2 minus root 2 into 1, that is minus root 2 plus of 1. So here you can observe, as it is a k minus root 2 and plus 1, we can't do anything related to this, because it is a root 2 and this is a 1. These are two different terms, yes. So now whatever the equation you got, you want the k value. For that you have to consider this is equal to 0. From this you have to find the k value. So for that, what you will do, you'll keep k here only. So this 2 and plus 1, you take that side, as it is the minus term, minus root 2. If it comes to the right hand side, it will become plus. So plus root 2, root 2, as it is a plus 1, if it comes to the right hand side, it will become minus 1. So k is equal to root 2 minus 1 is our answer. So let's observe the fourth problem. As you know that the factor given is x plus 1 is equal to 0, x minus 1 is equal to 0, so x is equal to 1. You have to substitute this x value in a given equation. So p of 1 is equal to k of x square, that means 1 square minus of 3 into the bracket 1 plus of k. So k into 1 square, 1 square is 1, k into 1 is k, minus 3 plus of k. Now this, you observe, this is a positive k, this is also positive k, that means it is 2, 1 plus 1, that is 2, as k term is common, k minus 3. Now you can't anything, is it possible to solve? No, Now you can consider this is equal to 0. If this equation is equal to 0, from this you have to find the k value, means you have to keep this one here only, as it is a 2k which is equal to minus 3. If minus 3 comes to the right hand side, it will become positive because the equal sign is there. Yes. So again you want the k value as it is a 2k. So k I will keep here only. This 2 is the multiple here. If it is a multiple, if it comes to the right hand side, it will divide the term. So it is 3 by 2. So this is a fourth answer. So we will continue in the next class. Just write down your homework question.